Let us study about the force exerted by a light beam on a surface. Here we can see there is a box on which a light beam emitted from a source of power P watt is incident. See, if the box is made up of a material which can be treated as a perfect black body, in this situation whatever radiation will fall on it will be perfectly absorbed by the box. So in this situation we can see as the source will emit photons in the beam, and we have discussed that each photon carries some momentum, and when the momentum is absorbed by a surface continuously it will exert a force on it. Say in this situation a force F is exerted, which can be written as the total amount of momentum exerted per unit time onto it. Now in this situation, if we calculate the rate of photon emission, then rate of photon emission from the source can be given as P lambda by Hc. This much amount of photons are emitted per unit time. And we know that the momentum of each photon is given as H by lambda. This also we have discussed in the previous sections. And now if we calculate the momentum imparted to surface per second. Now in this situation, momentum imparted per second can be written as a force exerted on the body, which is due to the absorption of a continuous momentum. This can be written as number of photons incident per second, which is P lambda by Hc multiplied by the momentum of each photon, that is H by lambda. Here H and lambda gets cancelled out and the value of force exerted we are getting is P by C. This is a very useful relation based on which many different concepts we are going to study, as well as various numerical applications. And this is the force P by C when the surface is acting like a black body. And if sometimes we are given that if a surface is reflecting, if it is considered to be perfectly reflecting in that situation, which are photons will incident on it? In case of reflecting surface, the same photon will be reflected in the opposite direction. So due to one incident photon, the change in momentum of the photon can be written as 2H by lambda, as it is an opposite direction reflection. So in this situation we can directly state the value of force in case of surfaces reflecting will be given as 2P by C, because the rate of photon emission is same, but change in momentum per unit time due to each photon will be twice of H by lambda. So it will be P lambda by Hc multiplied by 2H by lambda, that will be 2P by C. And if the surface is perfectly absorbing like a black body, the force is given as P by C, and in case of reflection it is 2P by C. Now in continuation, let's discuss about a situation if the surface on which the beam is incident is partially reflecting. It is not perfectly reflecting or absorbing. We can say it is partly reflecting, and it is given that it reflects 30% of light and absorbs 70% of light incident on it. Then this situation we can say the value of force exerted can be given as, it is 30% light is reflected, so 30% means it is 0.3 multiplied by 2P by C, plus 70% is absorbed, so it can be written as 0.7 multiplied by P by C. So the net force exerted on such a surface of which the reflection coefficient is 0.3 and the absorption coefficient is 0.7, this can be given as 1.3 P by C. That will be the force exerted on such a surface. Now depending on different ratio of reflection or absorption of light, we can easily calculate the value of force exerted by using this logic.